And to talk more about these changing weather conditions. And Mike, you were seeing some sun in our forecast. I'm looking way out there, right?
There is some light at the end of the tunnel on this one, and it does look like things are going to get better. Matter of fact, the rain has pretty much stopped now. Fort Collins, Greeley, a little bit continues in Boulder. And you saw some of the views we had around the metro area. They looked pretty dry. So that's the good news. Over much of metro Denver, things have really lightened up. To the south, that's what we're seeing when you're heading up on 285 and down to the south on 70 up into Mount Vernon Canyon on C-470 and E-470. Still some rain down that way, but it is definitely shrinking in coverage. Does extend back into Park County south of 285, but all of that is lighter than it has been. And even down in the Springs, although they've closed 24, a precaution there near Manitou, it's not raining very hard right now. So we're on the downside of this precipitation event, which has been just a massive one. You will notice a couple little pockets of snow. Generally, way up on the very tops, probably 11,500, 12,000 feet, we're seeing just a little snow for tonight. Rainfall amounts have been really amazing. These are the storm totals, just a scattering of them. A couple of different sources. You can go to my Facebook, which is Mike Nelson 7 News, Matt Makin's 247 Weather. He's got some great stuff on there. And also check out COCORAS, which is the Colorado Community Rain and Hail Study. Not only do they have the most comprehensive numbers as far as you can get, just about 5,000 different reporting stations, but they're also asking for your help on giving just any information you have about your experiences through this storm. And that'll all go to the Colorado Climate Center. Nolan Duskin, the state climatologist, is going to put a lot of this together. I have a link to that on my Facebook. Again, Mike Nelson, 7 News. And I think Matt's got one on his as well, Matt Makin's 247 Weather. So check those things out. They can really help us research this story a lot more further. And hopefully, if this happens again somewhere down the road, we have more understanding farther ahead of time to help people in what's going to be happening. It was a very rare situation. Last week, we had all that heat. It ended last Sunday when a cold front slid into the state. That front stalled, and that happens periodically. But what has been unusual is the stubborn monsoon flow that normally is cut off by this time in almost the fall, by this late summer. We get it in July and August, but not normally this late into the year. So that 1-2 combination of the punch coming in this way and the hook coming up this way created this rain machine that has been dumping on us for the last almost week. Now, in the last 24 hours, there actually was a slight reinforcement to that because there was another little cold front that slid in and sort of reinforced that stationary front, which had been weakening. It was weaker yesterday, but now that's where we squeezed out one more round of heavy precipitation today. Taking a look across the state tonight, the main action now is farther to the south. It's much lighter to the north, and Futurecast kind of gives us that sense going from now until 10 o'clock tonight, not much moisture lingering to the north, but a good band of it south of us. And frankly, for these folks, that's not going to be that bad. They still suffer from a severe drought over southeastern Colorado. They would welcome a couple of inches of rain down there, and we'd say good riddance, you can have it. We don't need it here. By morning, areas of dense fog expected to develop because there is so much moisture, and the sky is going back over to partly cloudy will mean temperatures drop down to the dew point, in other words, the point where the humidity would be 100%, and we should see some dense fog in the morning. And then during the day tomorrow, this system has weakened a lot. The monsoon flow is squeezing off finally. The front is diminishing. And so during the day tomorrow, we should not have a repeat performance of recent days. There will be some widely scattered showers and storms, not very many, but because there's so much low-level moisture in the atmosphere, there'll be enough fuel out there to give us some storms in the afternoon. Maybe not just tomorrow, but looking ahead as well into Tuesday and Wednesday. So rainfall amounts really shrinking down as far as additional rain to come. This event is winding up. We're almost done with it. And along the Front Range, additional rainfall, the heaviest looks like it will be on the south side of town. And most of that over the next few hours. Even this up here, another quarter inch might be a little overly done. As far as the conditions coming up for your Monday, it's going to be a cool start to the day. Really about where we should be this time of year, in the low to mid 50s with areas of fog, 40s to the west. And then tomorrow, 70s with a slight chance of some thunderstorms popping up. They will be small, widely scattered, but again, because there's so much moisture in the atmosphere, we will get some of them. Main story in the morning is we'll have some areas of fog forming, and that'll probably slow down some of the helicopter relief efforts. But the overall pattern this week looks good because that front is getting out of here. The monsoon flow is falling apart. And the 7-day forecast finally has some good news. There's a slight chance of rain Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Not very much. They'll be widely scattered. Thursday, there's a weak little front that's going to move in. Might stir up a few more showers. And then looking ahead to Friday and into next weekend, temperatures are going to be climbing up into the low to mid 80s and should stay dry. You know, typically, Mike and Ann, we get 15 inches of rain in a year. Some places have had more than that in 5 days, which is just unprecedented. We have had continuing coverage going on since noon today, and we'll continue until 7 o'clock this evening. We'll be right back after these messages.